is what Jesus says, his statements about reality true just for Christians who believe in him, or is it true for everyone? Now, some people might say at this point, you know, well, hey, that's good for you as a Christian. That's your truth, but I have my truth. If you say that you have a relative view, that there are no absolutes, that you're going to have to deal with a few problems. I will only give you one example. When a person says, well, I don't believe that there are any absolute truths in life, the very statement that they made then becomes an absolute statement. So then the argument that they've just made becomes a self-refuting argument, and the argument is defeated by their own statement. So there is such a thing as absolute truth. See, so what Jesus asserts about reality is not just one man's perception of reality, but Jesus, seeing things as clearly as they are in a non-distorted way, reports things as they truly are. So what he says is not just good for the Christian, it is also good for everyone, whether they believe in him or not. God will judge the world one day by Jesus Christ, whether you believe that or not. When we listen to the voice of Jesus, we listen to the voice of truth. See, in our world, there are many voices that are calling out to us, clamoring for our attention, wanting us to listen to them. And our job as Christians is to make sure that we hear and respond to the voice of truth. The world says to us, hey, you're young. You should enjoy your life. You can't possibly live pure. No one has done it in the world. And why would you even try? It's going to be futile. But the voice of truth says to us, I am able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before my throne with glory if you'll trust in me. The world says to us, hey, listen, there are many ways to God out here. Just pick one, whichever one suits you, and you'll make it to God in the end. But Jesus says to us, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The world says to us, seek your own world happiness. Make life about you. But the voice of truth says to us, die to yourself, live for God, and you will find the life that you're looking for. The world says to us, hey, listen, you're just one number in a big, giant world full of numbers, and you really don't have that much importance in this life. But the voice of truth says to us that God has numbered the hairs on our head. He knows us by name, and he knows us intimately. The world says to us, death is the finality. There's nothing more to life than death. Once you're in the grave, that's it, buddy. So live for today. But Jesus says to us, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me will never die. And if he were dead, yet shall he live again. The question that I have today is this. Whose voice are you going to believe? Will it be the voice of the world, or will it be the voice of truth? The voice of Jesus.